And welcome back to AHS Tiger Life, where the Arlington Tigers will take on the Cordova Wolves. Arlington coming off a mean win against the Bartlett Panthers, 15-1 going into Mercy Rule. And right after that, what also happened in that game, Tatum Biddick hit a mean in the park grand slam. My second time coming out here watching the game, I had never seen that before, and I just watched Tatum Biddick just run around those bases, get a grand slam. It was amazing. What do you think of it, man?
It was crazy. I was watching it from home. It was one of the craziest things to come out of this school sports.
For real, man. Oh. Yeah, here it is right here. Hits it down the left field. Bartlett Penn is trying to go out for it. But by the time they get to the ball, it's just way too late, man. Everybody gets around to the bases. High fives to everybody. Tatum Biddick around third base. Get there. And she's there. I'm telling you. Spectacular moment, man. I'm telling you. But she was about going 99 miles per hour around the bases, man. Seems like the Arlington Tigers are kind of going to be out on the field first.
Very promising group this year. What's it, 9-1 on the season now?
Shoot. Actually, they're 10-3. Mercy ruled the past two teams in a row. But for this Cordova game, looks like they're not going to be playing some of their prominent players. To want to take it easy in the varsity girls because, you know, not saying that Cordova isn't, you know, the most competitive team. It's just that, well, if I'm being honest, we don't want to waste our girls on that. Cordova starting lineup. Shakina Clark, number 11, third baseman. Anna Cockrell, number 3, catcher. Janae Conway, Trinity Fry, number 5. Nadine Martin, number 23. Widow Morris, number 12. Taylor Partain, number 10. Shamarik Poulin, number 2. Nadia Redfield, number 6. Shantae Tate, number 24. And Kyra Willis, number 22.
And for the Tigers, number 72, Julianne Roberts. Number 8, Jessica Olaw. Lily Hatch. Number 31, Lily Hatch. Number 2, Morgan Cooper. Number 30, Brooklyn Knight. Number 4, Brooklyn Juarez. Number 15, Rory Caldwell. Number 20, Brooklyn Hudson. And number 7, Emma Clemens.
Today's going to be a great game. Can't wait to see it. I'm looking for another Mercy Rule, to be completely honest with you, the way the Arlington Tigers have been out here dominating each other. Like I said before, being that this is not the most competitive game for the Arlington Tigers, they have been they decided to play their Arlington JV instead of the varsity, trying to, you know, not waste energy, you know, getting on this varsity squad. You know, want to get the younger girls get some experience. You know, it's always nice to see that.
Yeah, but Cordova is coming in here trying to put up a fight, so who knows what could happen.
Already 3 outs. Already looks like the Arlington Tigers gonna be going up the bat. Cordova going back in the field. Here's the Arlington Tigers getting ready. Ready to go back up the bat in a minute. I'm telling you, I'm not trying to be that guy, but I'm really expecting the Arlington Tigers just to steamroll the Cordova Wolves. But I think if Cordova can play all the right things, you know, do everything right that Arlington's doing wrong, they can really stay in this game. And it's pretty windy out here today. Also, the weather also does play a factor in this. Right up,
and a promising young pitcher coming from Cordova. Number 5, Trinity Fry, I believe. She is a junior coming out of Cordova. Very promising.
Hey, I haven't seen a lot from Trinity. Off the first couple of pitches, you know, looking pretty nice. But here we have the Arlington hype video, and here you go. The bat right here, we have JR or Julian Roberts. Only a young sophomore, multi-sport athlete, cross country, runs cross country, and also plays softball. One of the only left-handed batters.
Ball in the dirt by there from on the dirt by Trinity Fry. 2 balls, 0 strikes. Smack right over the dirt into left field.
That's just what you like to see, man. Getting off to a great start. JR getting on first base, kicking Arlington off on a good note.
Here comes Jessica Olaf, very promising young woman. On the dirt by Trinity Fry, and Julian Roberts advances to second base. Oh, hit by the pitch.
Easy walks.
And Jessica Ola goes to first base.
Trinity Fry getting off to a slow game. Star pitcher for the Cordova Wolves. Not doing so well so far. It's just the first 2 pitches, though. She'll get back in the rhythm of things.
Oh, a smack right to the middle.
Smack. And she drops the ball. Air. Golly, man. I'm telling you all, the Jabari curse is real, y'all. I'm trying out here, man. I'm trying. Like I said, also, man, if Arlington is any good as their playlist, man, we're winning state.
Comes Morgan Cooper, first base.
Good eye.
Ball in the dirt by Trinity Front.
Really windy out here today, man. It's very windy today.
Yeah, extremely. Oh,
another air as well. Oh, my goodness.
Got past the third base. Oh, and it goes over.
Just take it.
She's advancing. Advancing home. Safe.
Just Ola. Another Ola. Another run by the Arlington Tigers, 2-0.
It's getting bad already.
Brooklyn Knight, young sophomore.
Ball in the dirt by Trinity Fry and...
Oh, my goodness.
Lily Hatch advances to third base.
Trinity Fry getting off to a very slow start, man. You hate to see it, but, you know, there's a lot of time in this game. But, you know, I say that, but time usually runs out when you're up 15.
Ball in the dirt again.
Yeah, time usually runs out when you get mercy ruled 15. Well, hopefully they get one run. Brooklyn Knight, you know, a young, prominent sophomore, freshman year, played very well going into her sophomore year. Pitcher and hit these straight bombs, you know. Of also, when we talk about school, very, very wonderful personality in school. Very wonderful person as well. Translates that onto the softball field and plays very positive. You can see her talking to her teammates all the time. Just a loving characteristics all over the place, man. You love to see it. As I say that, Brooklyn Knight, you know, happily walks over to first base.
Here comes Brooklyn Juarez.
Right here we have another lefty batter.
Freshman. Brooklyn Juarez up at the plate. See if Trinity Fry can strike her. Good pitch.
If Brooklyn made contact with that, I'm telling you, bro, that would have been a home run right there, man. I'm telling you, the way she just swung that bat, bro.
Who knows?
Straight velocity. Whoa.
Morgan Cooper advances and scores another run for the Tigers.
Oh, my goodness, man. She's just like, I want to say that Cordova has time, but, like, man.
It's not looking too good, is it?
It's really not. It's really, really not. I'm telling you, you might get 50 runs in the first inning, man. It's looking bad.
Brooklyn Knight at second base scoring position. See if she can get home. A ball in the dirt again by Trinity Fry. And Brooklyn Knight advances to third base. Again, extremely windy. Plays a huge factor in this game. Outside.
A little 3-1 count right here. Trinity Fries, you know, star pitcher for the Cordova Wolves. Really getting on a slow start today, man. I don't know, man. Hopefully.
Maybe they can turn it around. Another pitch in the dirt.
As I say this, and Brooklyn Knight gets
a run.
Atta baby, Brooklyn.
Number 15.
And number 15, Rory Caldwell, center fielder, advances. Comes up to the plate.
Woo!
Oh, a smack to left. The Cordova person is here. They get the out. So that's one out and five runs for the Tigers.
Hey, man, that's one of the first good things that has happened for the Cordova Wolves, man. It's
not a good day.
Yeah, it's been rough. You know, it has been rough, but you know, anything can happen. They can make a little run.
And this is Brooklyn Hudson. Another pitch into Trinity Fry. Brooklyn Hudson is the catcher for the Tigers. A little bit outside. 3-1 count.
Oof. Foul.
2-2 count for Brooklyn Hudson.
I don't know much about Brooklyn Hudson, catcher for the Arlington Tigers. But off of first glance right here, the way she takes initiative on these swings right here.
Pitch
very, very patient, as you can see right here with that walk right there, man. Very disciplined softball player.
Emma Clemens coming up to the plate. Left fielder, freshman.
Who we got here, man? Emma Clements.
Got hit.
Oh, shoot. All right, how many times we going to get hit today, man? Look, Trinity, if you have something against us, man, just say that. Just say that.
Bases loaded as
Julian Roberts. Hold up now. You trying to see another grand slam? Little JR special grand slam?
Oh, wow.
Right down the middle.
Oh, wait, she dropped it.
Oh, she dropped it. Oh, my goodness.
What's happening? Wait.
What? Huh?
She's safe, isn't she?
What?
What is happening?
Listen, man. Listen, we're okay. All right. A lot
umpires are going to talk to it right now.
A lot just happened right there. As you can see right here, you know, JR smacks this thing
right down the middle.
He's a little running start as well, but you know, right there, for the center field to catch it, drops it, a little air. But then you see number 7, Emma Clements, tries to take base, but it seems like, you know, they got there before her. I think she's out, but
oh, she's safe.
Oh,
safe.
You know what? What did I say about that being out? I was just playing. She obviously got there first. I don't know what I was talking about. Yeah, man.
Umpires are explaining it to
Cordova's
coach.
You know, maybe I don't know much about softball. Maybe she got there first, man. Maybe that's just logic.
I think what happened was the person who hit it thought that they were out, so they turned around and stopped running and. I guess.
You know, I really want to see that replay one more time, because you know what, maybe my eyes deceive me, all right? Maybe my eyes deceive me, and, you know, she got there first, you know? But, you know, who knows, man? Who knows? But umpire still is trying to talk it over with the Cordova coach. Seems like, they're going to talk about it some more. Obviously, they have absolutely no idea what just happened, just like us.
Yeah. Very confusing.
There's a wasp in my face right now. Okay. All right. And it's gone. We're good. Good doctor chat. Poggers. Yeah, man. Umpire is still talking it over.
Very confusing play.
You know, very, 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 very confusing. Myself, I have no idea what just happened. First, I thought the center fielder caught it. I was like, oh, crap. Mm-hmm. You know, but then I see the ball on the ground. I'm like, oh, shoot. You know, we still got potential for a little grand slam. Seems like we have a, you know, a little decision on the call. We can run this replay one more time. As you can see, JR
smacks it down
the middle. As we all think, the center field's trying to catch it. Drops it. A little air on the play.
It's like she caught it and then dropped it. It was so crazy. And then, she obviously got there first, though.
Yeah, that's what I'm saying. Like, she got there first. It's just, you know what?
Very complicated.
The camera's lying to you, all right? JR got there first. Don't believe what you see.
Oh, wow. Second base is still there. And number 8, Jessica Ola, third base, coming to hit. High and outside from Fry. Base is loaded. Let's see what can happen.
Right down the middle.
Strike. 1-1 count. The Wolves have one out.
how much do you want to bet, Alex? How much do you want to bet?
It might.
That the Arlington Tigers.
Oh, my God. Foul.
Very close to a foul.
How much do you want to bet?
That would have been a grand slam.
You know, the way the Arlington Tigers have been playing for the past couple games and just mercy ruling every team, how much do you want to bet that the Arlington Tigers mercy rules the Cordova Wolves in the first inning?
I'd say it's about 30-70 odds, but I don't think it will go past the second inning.
If they keep up this pace, they are just beating down the Wolves right now. It's getting bad.
Want to put money on it?
I'm broke, dude.
You know who else is broke? The Cordova.
She's out. That was close. And that is number 7. Emma Clemens is out.
But we, you know, Arlington Tigers still get a run. 7-0 in the first inning. Bottom of the
two outs. Two outs.
Hopefully, Cordova did a quick out right here to get back to batting and try to put some points on the board, man.
And there's Willie Hatch at the plate, shortstop, and outside.
Ball one. Two outs for the Wolves. 7-0 Arlington.
Ooh. That would have been foul.
Oh, calls that out. It's not a foul. Calls that out. And the Cordova Wolves are ready to get back out there.
Yeah.
Arlington Tigers is also ready to get back out on the field side of things. Hopefully Cordova can, you know, lock in and tee up and try to get some points on the board, man.
Who knows? We'll see what happens. Only time will tell.
And last time we
– here's a replay. Of
last time
happened.
We were out here, man, the Cordova Wolves went against the Arlington Tigers and lost 17-0. Yeah, that's right. You heard me right. 17-0. No mercy rule, y'all. 17-0. Absolutely dominated Cordova Wolves. Addie Graham out there just killing it, along with some of her Kendall Wilkie, Brilly Bunker, Tatum Biddick, just all getting out there, getting some touches on the ball. To be completely honest with you, it was a bloodbath, y'all. And Arlington Tigers are looking to do the same thing, but only look. Arlington Tigers looking to do the same thing, but this time with their JV team.
See what happens. Brooklyn Knight at the mound, having a really great game so far, shutting him out.
Hey, let's also talk about how Brooklyn Knight has been killing it on the pitching side of things, man. I mean, obviously, we haven't been seeing a lot of it. This is the second time coming out here pitching because, you know, the Tigers have been absolutely dominating when it comes to batting. But, you know, Brooklyn Knight also just doing spectacular job on the pitching side of things.
This is Arlen.
Right here we have number 24, Shante Tate. Whoa, Shante Tate.
Oh, big hit.
Show him what you got, Shante. Show him what you got, Shante. You know, hits it, line drive down there in left field, man. Hopefully, you know, Alex, this can spark something for the Toad and the Wolves, man. Real trying to make this a little bit interesting, making, you know, 7-0, top of the second, not the most interesting game, but you know, it is what it is.
Strike one for Brooklyn Knight. What a great game so far.
Ooh, strike two?
Yeah, strike two.
I'm telling you, man, Brooklyn Knight having doing pretty well out here, man, by this. Looking to strike her out.
We'll see.
Ooh.
A little bit high. Ball one.
This is number 22, Kyra Willis. Ooh.
Oh, foul ball. Good contact there.
I mean, that's all you can do, man. You know, yeah. That's all you can do, man. Try to get a feel for it, and when the time is right, smack that thing out of here. Oh.
Oh, foul again.
Catcher tried to get that right there.
Brooklyn Hudson, real close, too.
Hold up. Ooh, seemed pretty low right there. Right here. Full count right here. Oh, straight.
Good contact, but straight to the first baseman.
Smart play to tag her out right there. You know, Cordova not known for their softball, known for more of their basketball. You know, they are killer when it comes to basketball, you know, but softball, they're still rebuilding, looking to start off in a good place. But, you know, right here we have number 11, Clark, number 11 Clark. I'm not butchering that. You know what? No, I'm going to try. Alex, you want to try that?
Number 11, Shanika. Or Shakina. Shakina Nia.
Well, Shakina Nia hits it. Oh.
We were not paying attention.
Shakina Nia did not.
I heard her bat was made from aluminum, the same metal that Wolverine's claws were made from.
I did not know that. She keep.
Oh, wow.
Absolutely smooth pop fly. Oh, easy for
that was Brooklyn Morris. Brooklyn Morris.
Light work for Brooklyn right there.
Oh, wow. The coach is coming out there and yelling at number 24 for the Cordova Wolves.
Shante Tate trying to get it head right. One of our spectacular. Oh, okay.
Sorry if we wait, buddy.
When we got put on a team for Little League at the Arlington Complex. I was 3 when I started out with T-ball. I started pitching when I was 9 because I just thought it was cool. This season, I feel like we're going to lose some, but I feel like when it gets to districts and regionals and sub-state, I feel like we are going to like come together. My future, I feel like I'm going to do college, try to do 4 years of college, and after that, I'll probably just start my job.
As you see right there, Brittany Layton, you know, a spectacular pitcher for the Arlington Tigers. Not playing today, try to give her a break against his Cordova squad. But, you know, switched between catcher to pitcher. Already making a killing at catcher, decided, you know what, it's getting a little bit too easy out here. Just like Addie Graham, playing all positions, moving to shortstop. Just like Addie, getting a little bit too boring out here. Let me see what's up in the pitcher side of things. And, you know, for the last couple games, she's just struggling everybody out. Mercy ruled every team. Not every team, but the past two games, Mercy ruled the past two teams. And it's just been, you know, it's been a great season for Brittany so far. You love to see it. But, Arlington Tigers ready to get back out here on the batting side of things. And it's already 7-0, but, you know, if the Arlington Tigers can, you know, get the same amount of points again. We're halfway. We're already 1 point away to Mercy Rule, man.
Let's see what, is this in for Morgan Cooper can do, first baseman. Good shooting, dude. Let's see if Fry can turn this game around.
Got a little piece of it right there. Just a piece. You know, the umpire here, young Billy Tate, at Billy Tate on Twitter, you know, talked to him, a spectacular guy.
Yeah.
Actually, right behind the catch right here. You know, spectacular dude, and really just calling this game in between, man. You love to see it.
I heard he used to play college ball in Florida for the Florida State Seminoles. smack right through the third baseman. Oh, wow, she dropped it.
Oh,
my God, they dropped it again. Second base by, advances to second base by Morgan Cooper. Good job. Number 30, Brooklyn Knight.
Right here, comes to the plate. Great. It's effort. A line drive. Still finds a way to mess it up, man. Oh, my goodness. I'm telling you.
Strike one for Fry.
The Cordova Wolves, man, they came out here looking for something and they're just getting nothing, man. It's everything is just going wrong on their side, and hopefully they can just find a way to just
outside.
Hopefully close, they can close, just find close. A way to just get back into this game.
So after she says take four, count to one though.
Let's see here, Brooklyn Knight. Pitcher, hitting up the bat right here.
Mm-hmm. Ooh.
Oh, that's foul.
That's foul. Foul ball. I actually heard that the softballs were hand sewn by monks.
See right here. Oh my goodness.
Oh.
Line drive.
Oh, that's
straight
to the wall.
Thanks.
See if she can get
Brooklyn.
Home here.
Oh,
yeah.
She can get home.
She can get home. All the way to triple. He's stopping her. Man, that's still a great play. That's still a great play. Brings a
great hit.
Morgan Cooper home.
Great hit by Brooklyn Knight, man.
Here comes Brooklyn Juarez. Brooklyn Juarez, right fielder.
Brooklyn to Brooklyn, back to back. Hopefully Brooklyn can get it to this run. As you hear, Brooklyn Knight hits it. Mean little line drive to right field. Look at the strides. Look at the strides. Get there. Got there. Third. As you got here, Brooklyn Juarez getting ready to go crazy right here. This, you know, I'm thinking the same thing, man. It's 8-0. Hoping the Cordova can get back out here. You know, hopefully the star pitcher.
Pitching the dirt by Fry.
Star pitcher Trinity Fry can find a way to get the Cordovas back on the batting side.
Way high, way high as Brooklyn Juarez is walking. Number 15, Rory Caldwell coming up to the plate, center fielder.
Young freshman Rory Caldwell. Promising young talent. Back in one of the best players on the middle school softball team. You know, getting developed by the varsity program. For sure going to be a star in the next coming years.
Yeah. So you can see Brooklyn Knight is still at third base. Let's see if she can bring her home. Right here. A little bit high.
A Good eye by Rory Cardwell here.
This could be a walk.
The way things have been going, man, I would not be surprised.
We'll see.
Oh, a smack.
We ain't
right,
got time for
right,
no walk. We only got time for runs. Shout out Brooklyn Knight getting down to home plate.
Right through the two defenders there.
As you can see right here, Brindley Caldwell right between the two fielders right there. It's just been one of those days, man. Just one of those days for Cordova. Like you can see, number 20, Brooklyn Hudson. That's three Brooklyns on the
Arlington roster.
On the Arlington roster, man. All of them having a spectacular day. It must be Brooklyn Day. Crickets.
Oh, pitch in the dirt by Fry. Brooklyn Roars advances to third.
Ooh,
what happened to her?
Brooklyn low-key. I think she tweaked her ankle there on third base right there. But
I think she'll be fine.
I think she's going to walk it off. Hopefully Brooklyn can get Brooklyn down to get this run. Ooh,
number 20.
Pitch in the dirt by Fry right there.
Still Brooklyn swung at it.
Not a great day for the Wolves. It's not going too well.
Hopefully they can come back into it, man. You know, you know it's the game ain't over till you get to 15. So
it will. True. Another pitch in the dirt.
Well, I mean they can still get the 15, you know, but hopefully, you know, Cordova can get some points on the board.
At least one or two. Yeah, like this is
good. They'll still get mercy rule, but you know, at least they can get some points on the board, you know, just to, you know, feel better about themselves. Another walk by the Trinity Fry throwing another walk there. Not the best day for Trinity Fry, man. Star pitcher for the Cordova Wolves. Not having the greatest day. As I say that, you know, starting to get a little good going. Dang!
Strike right there, and third base is loaded. I mean, all bases are loaded right here.
Sorry about that, guys. Like I said, you know, starting to go on a good track with the strike there.
Another pitch in the dirt. This is not a great game.
Hey, man, you just gotta have hope. And I have hope in our Cordova, the Cordova Wolves. I have hope. They can come back in this game and they can, you know, make this challenging for the Arlington Tigers. As I say that.
Foul ball.
Just kidding.
Foul ball.
I'm telling you, man, number seven, Emma Clements just getting some touches here.
Left fielder, very promising. Two count for Fry. Let's see if she can get her first strikeout of the day, maybe. Who knows? We'll see.
Ooh, you ain't lying. I don't think we have seen a strikeout.
Yeah.
Have we?
I thought that was good, man. I thought that was a strike. But I guess not.
Hey, Billy did not see Billy didn't see
Billy
how
Taint.
We saw it.
Billy Taint.
Like I said, go shout him out. Billy Taint on Twitter. Yeah. Very nice guy. He told me to say this, by the way.
Yeah.
As Brooklyn gets a run, it's now 10-0
number
for the Arlington Tigers.
Number 72, Julianne Roberts comes back to the plate. Second base. Very windy out here.
You know, I don't want to be that guy, but what are the chances? Right, what are the chances we get mercy rule at the bottom of the second? Yeah, it's not looking too good. It probably is going to happen. Now, I'm not saying it's going to happen. I want to see the Cordova Wolves get at least 1 point on the board, right? But if they don't.
Ball on the dirt. Okay. This is not a great game for her at all.
Trinity Fried and five star pitcher for the Cordova Wolves. I've said that so many times, and yet the game that she's having so far is not proved to be true. As I say that,
that's high. Another 3-0 count. 3-0 count. She's gonna walk a person home here.
And it's and the bases are loaded, man. It's just, yep, about to walk somebody home, man.
She walks somebody home. That'll be Rory Coldwell, the center fielder, coming home.
Wow.
Oh wow, way high.
Wow.
Way high. That is not good.
Number eight, Jessica Ola.
11 points. This is not good at all.
Thanks for the coach. Hey man. Like I said before, man, W playlist. W walkouts by the Arlington Tigers, man.
Another ball. Pitch in the dirt, man.
Hey, man. Hey, man. Just, sometimes it's just not your day, man. And today, Trinity is not having that day. Like, at this point, you have to think about switching out the pitchers, right? Like, at some point, you have to think about switching out the pitchers.
Yeah, this is not a good game for her at all.
But that being said, I don't think they – I think this might be their only pitcher.
Strike. Strike right there.
Oh, hold up now. As I say that, gets a strike. You know, maybe this might be a turn in the right direction.
Just a bit outside right there.
You really just hate to see it on the Cordova side, man. Really. Really just hits. I think we might be I think we could get lunch early. What time is it? 5:42? Hey, man.
Just a bit outside right there. A little bit high.
I'm telling you, I'm going to be a bit outside of Arlington High School because, my goodness.
Gosh.
We might be getting the Mercy Rule. And I think I got a little taste for Chipotle, man. What do you think?
Who knows? I guess we'll see.
Oh, wow.
Oh, smack to left field.
And another error.
Oh,
my
let's see
goodness.
How many, oh, let's
one,
see how many
that's another
out.
One. It's DJ Khaled, another
let's
one.
Get, oh. What do you mean? That is not a good call at all. The ball was not in her glove.
Right here,
that should not be. That should not
Jessica
be
Ola absolutely smacks it, right? Now, this should be an easy, right, easy catch. But Cordova, again, another error. And then, as you can see, everybody, you know, getting touches. Everybody get a touch on the base, man. Get a touch on the home base, man. As you can see, 13-0. I want to fix that right there, but a little bit high there.
A little bit high, just a bit outside right there.
But if you are on camera right now, you need to stay with the MAP students because you're their teacher.
There you go. Gonna fix it right there. Right here, as you can see, we got number 31, Lily Hatch. It's a foul ball. Only 2 points away from a mercy rule. I'm telling you, man. You know, all she has to do is hit a home run. Ooh, that would have been insane if she just hit a home run right there as soon as I said that.
I heard number five was maybe picking up a bowling career at her school.
Well, the way she's been throwing balls at the ground, I would not be surprised.
I hope Trinity. This is not a good game.
I hope Trinity can get it
or
together.
Or skee ball. Just a little outside right there, a little bit high.
You know, hope like listen.
I really do hope that Trinity can get the Cordova Wolves back in the game. But the way it's looking right now, man, it's 13-0. Not a lot of good things to say.
Oh, pass the third baseman right there as number 72, Julianne Roberts, comes home, the second baseman.
Guys,
she's having a great game.
I'm trying to find something good to say about the Cordova Wolves' performance this game, but everything is going wrong. Error after error after error. Mistake after mistake after mistake. At some point, you just have to realize that everything's just going wrong. As you can see right here, right in front of third baseman, it's just another mistake. It's just mistake.
Oh gosh, sorry.
Sorry, guys. Almost got taken out. Hey, y'all, that's me.
Wait. Can they see us? Oh, you can see me. That's right there. That's pretty cool. This is Morgan Cooper at bat right here. She is the Morgan Cooper is the first baseman, having a good game too. In the dirt.
As you can see right here, hopefully, you know, 1 point away from Mercy Rule. It's
However, no runners in scoring position. I'm in that position, so.
So hopefully, you know, Trinity.
Oh,
you know,
yeah,
what?
Never
forget
mind.
What we
never
said,
mind.
Man. It's everything's going wrong.
Oh, I thought that was home.
And the way it's looking.
Yeah, that's game. That's
I'm
game
starting
right
to
here.
Think that's a wrap.
Game over.
Get touches, man.
Game over.
And that's game. As you can
over.
See right here.
That is
number
over.
Two, Morgan Cooper absolutely smacks it. Line drive all the way down there. Hits the fence. You know what? You know what?
Playing.
Oh, we're still going.
I guess we're still
you know
playing.
What? Why not the score?
This is going to get way worse. Oh, my God. Sorry, guys.
The weather is, you know, like I said, the weather is making a real impact on us right now. Dust just flew in our eyes, you know. No else is flowing in our eyes.
This is the pitcher.
Absolute dominance. But it's like another. My bad.
A lot of dirt, but this is the pitcher coming up. She's had a great game. Absolute shutout right here. No runs for the Wolves. Just a bit outside right there.
No, why?
I understand now, like, since it's getting so bad, but why would you not change the pitcher sooner? Like, she is not having a good game at all. There is no point to keep her in.
To be completely honest with you, man, I really don't think they have another pitcher.
There's
got to
be someone. Just take the second baseman.
This is their only pitcher, I swear.
Smack to right field.
Oh, my goodness.
She let it go.
I am trying out here, man. I am trying.
Get the second baseman or something, dude. Get her off the mound at this point. Like, this is not good at all.
I am trying everything in my power to say something good about the Cordova Wolves. Brooklyn Knight smacks it. Hit them shot. She jogged
to first base. Pitch in the dirt.
Brooklyn Knight could have took that. And she said, you know what? I don't want it. I don't.
This is not good at all. This is Brooklyn Juarez at the plate right here. Okay.
You know, I'm really hoping that, you know, Cordova can find something in their heart to just come back into this game, man. It's not, you know, not the, you know, you hate to see 16-0.
Yes, yeah, not looking good.
But, you know, if they can just come together as a team, and, you know, maybe things can change.
Strike, she swung. That's...
Wait.
Is this a pinch hitter coming?
What's happening? Was that a strikeout?
Was that a...
That was a strikeout.
That was a strikeout?
That's the first strikeout
first
for
strikeout
Trinity
of the game
Fry in the game. See, we're stepping in the right direction. Wait, they're stepping in the right direction for the Cordova Wolves here, man. That's what you like to see. Hopefully they can, you know, take advantage of this.
Momentum. Newfound momentum. See what they can do. First strike. hopefully a mini.
I really do think that Cordova is just trying to end the game here.
Oh, strike two. Maybe another strikeout right here?
You okay, buddy?
Yeah.
Dirt again flew over here. It's been right into my eyes. It's getting kind of windy down here. Like I said, the wind is playing a major factor. Maybe that's one of the reasons why things haven't been going good for Cordova Wolves.
I don't think that can explain
this.
Yep,
and that's into the ball. On, like, it, you know what? What can, I'm... Like, at some point, you have to change the pitcher, man. You have to. Because it's terrible. Like, she's having not the best game.
Just a bit outside, a little bit high right there, but who knows?
Not maybe having the best game. At some point, you have to switch out the pitchers, man. I'm really convinced that this might be the only pitcher that they have.
Yeah, I mean, but, like, at this point, it's just. This is just getting bad. I would take anyone, honestly.
And I
strikeout right there. That's strikeout number two on the game.
And I,
is that it?
Hi, I'm Smokey Bear, and I made an assistant to help you out. Because only you can prevent wildfires.
Hey, Assistant Smokey Bear, call me Papa Bear, because I'm grilling up dinner. Do you get it?
Yes, good job.
So, what should I do with all these coals?
Don't just toss them out. Put them in a metal container, because those embers can start a wildfire.
I understand. The stakes are high.
Ha, 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 ha.
See, Smokey thinks I'm funny.
We're back. Coming back with Hannah Horner and Addison Bradley. First up to hit, we have number 23, Nadia. Can y'all hear us? Like, a good hit by 23, and a good catch by Brooklyn Juarez.
I know what's going on. I just don't know. Are we supposed to start?
Mm-hmm. Next up, we have number two. Straight down the middle. Low hit. Next up, we have their catcher, number three, Anna Cockrell. We've seen a pretty good game so far, 16 leading Arlington. Cordova still at zero.
Ball a little out of the strike zone.
Last inning was actually a pretty good 9 hits,
yeah.
9 runs
yeah.
for the Arlington Tigers. Cordova just couldn't seem to get any good pitches and to stop them.
Cordova has one runner on base.
Number two is currently on base. Strike one for number three.
Hannah Horner.
They currently have 2 balls. Second strike. Oh. Let's see if she can bring it. And gets it out. Pop fly.
Out by Morgan.
Some of this wind could be throwing off the Cordova Wolves. Seems to be not really affecting the Arlington Tigers this game. They're still leading 16-0. Two outs for the Arlington Tigers.
Brooklyn Nine's been doing pretty good at the pitcher's mound.
She really has. We've seen no runs allowed from the Cordova Wolves.
No, infield's doing really well.
It's up.
Caught by Brooklyn Nine.
It was a quick top inning for the Arlington Tigers. Coming back, we'll have the Tigers hitting and Cordova Wolves in the field.
For the box score, there's 16 runs by...
What a mercy rule by Arlington Tigers.
Yeah, Arlington Tigers leading with 16, Cordova with 0.
They had 4 errors from the Cordova Wolves. 7 hits and
9 runs.
9 runs in the second inning and 7 runs in the first. It's a pretty good game to watch, I think so. But I'd love to see some more games. They continue their streak of their mercy rule.
Yeah, pretty quick game though.
It was a quick game.
All right, that's the end of our game. Thanks for watching. Good night.